Good evening, everyone. And how in a crowd like we have here can we not mention as well to those who are watching in America, happy Thanksgiving as well. As students are still filing in, we're going to begin. By way of introduction, my name is Dov Lipman. A short 26 years ago, I was one of you, an 18-year-old who was blessed with the opportunity to come and study Torah in Israel after high school. I moved to Israel 11 years ago with my wife and family and was honored to serve as a member of the Knesset in the 19th Knesset. We are here tonight to pay tribute to all victims of terror and to all the lives that have been lost. That terror has hit very close to home. We can now, all of us here, can now understand the depth of suffering that is being experienced throughout our country. And all of us now have a face and we have a story which we can relate to. Ezra Schwartz. A week ago, Ezra was just one of the guys. Now, Ezra has become a hero. A week ago, Ezra was known to his family and his friends. Now, Ezra is known worldwide. Two summers ago, a young American named Max Steinberg was killed while defending Israel as a lone soldier in the Israeli Defense Force. On his tombstone at Mount Herzl Military Cemetery in Yerushalayim, one of his favorite quotes is engraved. No, it's not from the Tanakh, and no, it's not from the Gemara. It's from Bob Marley. And the quote reads, "Live for yourself, and you live in vain. Live for others, and you live forever." That quote most certainly applies to Ezra Schwartz, Zichrono Levracha. In just 1 week, all of Am Yisrael has learned about Ezra's giving nature. We learned how Ezra gave of himself to be a dedicated big brother, to bond with his older sister, and to be a devoted son and grandson. We learned that Ezra donated his bar mitzvah money to United Hatzalah, the very organization that rushes to save lives throughout Israel. We learned about how Ezra gave of himself to the young children at the school in Boston where he chose to volunteer during high school. We learned about how Ezra took the younger players under his wing and served as a mentor for them on the Maimonides baseball team. We learned how Ezra chose to attend a yeshiva which has volunteering as part of its regular schedule. We learned about how Ezra made people around him smile and laugh. And we learned how Ezra pushed himself to get out of bed last Thursday to go volunteer in Gush Etzion, a mission during which he was killed just because he was a Jew in the land of Israel. Ezra Schwartz lived for others, and now Ezra Schwartz lives forever. Ezra has been taken from us physically, but the memories that he created live on. And the example that he set in 18 short years will serve as a source of inspiration for all of us forever. Tonight, we, the collective we, those of us here in the audience and those who are watching via live stream, especially in Boston and other places, all of Am Yisrael together. We come together to remember Ezra, to connect to Ezra, and to learn from Ezra. We also come together tonight to make the collective statement that our enemies cannot stop us. Despite their ruthless killing, and despite the suffering this causes among our people, we are here to stay. We will continue to live in our land. We will continue to learn Torah in our land. We will continue to do chesed in our land. And we will continue to tour and just have fun in our land. Tonight's program will include Tehillim, speeches, slideshow, music, and learning the entire Tanakh together. A gathering of this kind, especially on such short notice, does not happen on its own. And before we begin tonight's program, a few short thank yous are in order. We thank Kiryat Chinuch of Beit Shemesh and Yeshivat Ashrenu for hosting us. We thank the Beit Shemesh municipality and especially the Beit Shemesh police who are here as well for their assistance. We thank the sponsors of tonight's program, Masa Yeshiva University, the Orthodox Union, NCSY, and OU Israel. And most importantly, we thank the Rashi Yeshiva and heads of school of all of your yeshivot and seminaries. I don't know if you all realize how dedicated they are to you, to taking care of you, and to making sure you have the best year possible. They are all special and remarkable people. We begin tonight's program with Tehillim in memory of Ezra, Yechiel Ezra ben Ari Yonah, along with all those who have lost their lives, and also as a prayer that the people of Israel should be protected from its enemies. The Tehillim, which I believe will appear on the screens, will be led by someone very special. The Tehillim are going to be led by a man named Simon. Simon was the driver of the van that Ezra was traveling in when he was killed. I'd like to call on Simon right now to the podium to lead us in the Tehillim.
Рамалот. Мима маким кратиха Адонай.
Шира малот, мима маким кратиха Адонай.
Адонай шма беколим. Тигьена ознеха кашувот леколь тахануной. Им аванот тишмар я Адонай ми ямот.
Им аванот тишмар я Адонай ми ямот.
Ким хас лихаль ман тиваре.
Ким хас лихаль ман
тиваре. Кивите Адонай кифта навши уле дворо халти.
Кивите Адонай кифта навши уле дворо халти.
Навшила Адонай ми шамрим лабокер, шамрим лабокер.
Навшила Адонай ми шамрим лабокер, шамрим лабокер.
Яхел Исраэл Адонай, ким Адонай ахесед ви абе имо пдут.
Яхел Исраэл Адонай, ким Адонай ахесед ви абе имо пдут.
Веху ибде эт Исраэл миколь аванотав.
Who is that Israel we call Adonai?
Please be seated. Rav Meir Lichtenstein is the Rav of Ohel Yonah Menachem in Beit Shemesh and a Rav to Ashrenu's Rosh Yeshiva, Rabbi Yudin. He is the son of Rav Aaron Lichtenstein, Zecher Tzadik Livracha, who was one of the founders of the very concept of gap year programs in Israel, and also from Alon Shvut, which is the area where Ezra was killed. Rav Lichtenstein is the grandson of Rav Yosef Dov Soloveitchik, Zecher Tzadik Livracha, the Rav of Boston, the founder of Maimonides, where Ezra went to school, and whose model of commitment to Torah while also being involved in trying to better our world and our society is truly embodied by the Schwartz family and by the way Ezra lived his life. It is therefore fitting that we call on Rav Lichtenstein to share some words of inspiration with us at this time.
I Good evening. Can you hear me? Shalom, good evening. On behalf of the Beit Shemesh community, I welcome all of you here to our city, upset about the circumstances. Dov mentioned that he came in Aliyah 11 years ago. Well, I came in Aliyah in 1971, so you can calculate later how many years I've been living in Israel. Many of them I've spent in Alon Shvut in Gush Etzion, where Ezra was murdered. Naturally, Ezra's murder raises many emotions and many, many questions. On the one hand, sorrow and mourning the loss of the young life of an innocent young man that was taken so cruelly and suddenly. And also, I assume many of you, being here for less time than I'm here, for 4 months, have many questions about your role here in Israel in these days. Ezra wasn't murdered because who he was personally, not for his personality. Ezra was a shliach tzibur. Ezra was a korban tzibur. Because terror wants to kill all of us. And any one of us could have been in Ezra's place. Rav Chaim Sabato, Mishiva Male Adumim, describes in his book, Ti'um Kavanot, in the English title, Adjusting Sights, the story of his Yom Kippur War. In the center of the story is his search after his friend, Dov Indig, Hashem Yikom Domo. And there's a question which is not answered in the book. Rav Chaim and Dov grew together. They went to the same school. They left Jerusalem to the war together. And Rav Chaim doesn't understand why, if they're so similar, why did he return home and Dov, Hashem Yikom Domo, remained in the battlefield? Rav Sabato gives us a lesson in faith and emuna. We should ask questions. It's good to experience questions, but we should know that we don't always have answers to all questions. This message was central in the thought of my grandfather, the Rav Zecher Tzadik Livracha, who dealt intensively in his writings with how to experience evil and bad. And one of the major messages that the Rav taught us is that we don't have to deny evil as evil. We don't have to deny our feeling of sorrow and of not understanding. But together with that, the Rav taught us that the way to stand in front of evil is not to ask why evil occurs, but to ask what should we do. We can choose how to respond. We can give meaning to what happened to us. We can take Ezra's death and ignore it and just continue. And we can choose to take Ezra's death, to learn from him, and to give meaning to his life and to his death, and to make it an establishing experience in our own lives. I would like to address your being here in Israel, going through this experience. Maybe you thought this is the story of Israel, and you came here to be spectators, maybe to have a year of fun, to look at us, at the Israelis living here, and then go home back to the United States. Well, you know you're wrong. You are part of the story. I knew Rav Yaakov Don, Hashem Yikom Damo, who was killed together with Ezra for over 30 years. I remember him entering the yeshiva in Alon Shvut. I'm a few years older than him, when he was in his first year. And in a big yeshiva, when a Shana Aleph guy comes in, you don't always notice him. There are maybe 60 or 70 of them. But Rav Yaakov was always noticeable. He had a loud voice, big presence. And he was killed together with Ezra at the doorstep of his home in Alon Shvut. You could have thought there's no larger distance between a young 18-year-old American boy killed together with a person living for 30 years in Gush Etzion. But they have the same story, because this is the story of the Jewish people. And maybe now we also realize this is maybe the story of the free world confronting the evil of the Islamic terror. We are now in a war. There's a global war fighting terror. And in this war, unlike the Yom Kippur War, where the front line was in the Golan Heights and the Sinai deserts, the front line now is in our backyards, in every bus stop, in every bus, in every crossroad that we go. And all of us are soldiers. And soldiers have a mission. And here we need special heroism, which is maybe different from what all of us have always imagined. The heroism of the little actions, what we call in Hebrew the ma'asim haktanim. Rav Sabato, in his book, describes a conversation he had with his friend Dov years before the war. When they were discussing a story they heard together from one of their teachers when they were in elementary school, going on a trip to Tveria, and he told them the story about Rabbi Hanina ben Tradion, who was one of the Asar Harugei Malchut. And the Gemara describes, I'll translate it into English, that when Rabbi Yossi ben Kisma was sick, Rabbi Hanina ben Tradion went to visit him. And he turned to Rabbi Hanina ben Tradion and he said to him, "Don't you know that this nation, the Romans, God has crowned them over the world. He let them destroy his home and kill his Hasidim. And they're still ruling the world. And I heard about you. You're endangering your life, that you're sitting and teaching Torah and having a Sefer Torah in your lap. It's dangerous." Rav Hanina ben Tradion said to him, "Min hashamayim yirachemu. God will have mercy on us." Said to him Rabbi Yossi ben Kisma, "I'm telling you words of sense, of logic, and you're telling me, min hashamayim yirachemu? I wonder if they won't burn you on the Sefer Torah and the Eish, if you won't be a martyr yourself." So turned Rabbi Hanina ben Tradion to Rabbi Yossi ben Kisma, and he said to him, "Rabbi, ma ani lechaye olam haba? Will I go to the eternal world?" So he asked him, "Klum ma'aseh baliyatcha? Do you have any good act or deed you once did?" So he said to him, "Yes, once I had the tzedakah money of Purim, and I switched it mistakenly with the tzedakah money, which was not for Purim, and I gave all the money to poor people." Said to him Rabbi Yossi ben Kisma, "If so, I want to be together with you. Michelkecha yichelki, migorelcha yigorali." Rav Sabato describes the conversation he had with Dov, how to understand this conversation between Rabbi Hanina ben Tradion and Rabbi Yossi ben Kisma. And he brings the following explanation in the name of Dov. I want to read it. Yesh ma'asim v'yesh ma'asim. There are actions and deeds and there are deeds. Yesh ma'asim gdolim. There are great actions. V'osim otam anashim gdolim. Great men do them in great hours and everybody knows about them. V'yesh ma'asim shenirim ktanim. But there are small actions that we do them in simple days and nobody knows we do them. That's like the money that changes in the contrast to what Rav Hanina ben Tradion did with the Kehilot Barabim. And said Rav Dov Indog, Hashem Yikom Damo, Be'emet, Heim ha-ma'asim ha-gdolim, Ve'em ha-mi'idim, Ma'u ha-adam la'olam haba. What brings us to Olam Haba is not the great actions, but our little actions. Now is a time of habits, of little actions. You are called, you are soldiers in the front here, and you are part of us. You think you belong to America. It's Thanksgiving today. But you are here in Eretz Yisrael, the land of the Jewish people, the land of all of us. And from here I call you upon the Toshavim, the inhabitants of Eretz Yisrael, of Beit Shemesh. Stay with us. Stay till the end of this year. Don't go home. You have a mission to be part of us here. I'm sure your parents will back you, understand their difficulty, but ask them to allow you to stay here and know that you are part of the great story of the Jewish nation and appreciate your parents' support that they hopefully will give you. In this week's parsha, we're going to lean to on Shabbat, how Yaakov Avinu gets ready to fight Esav. And he teaches us the Jewish way. On the one hand, the Jew tries to do what he can and he asks, "What should I do?" That is what Chazal described. He prepared himself for war and for Doron, for diplomacy. On the other hand, he prepares himself for tefillah. He turns to God, Shiatzliach Darko. We will do the same. We will ask at Ezra's gravestone, "What do we have to do? What can we do, what can we do better that we did not do till now? What little actions can we do? Come in time to Seder, be better to your friend, do more chesed." And Bezrat Hashem, the Kodesh Baruch Hu, will see that we are committed to stay here and to live a Torah life in Eretz Yisrael, and He will bless our nation. Kol Tov.
Thank you, Rabbi Lichtenstein, for those words of inspiration. Ezra's death and the events since his death, including the funeral at Ben-Gurion Airport, the funeral in Boston, and even the moment of silence before the Patriots game on Monday night, have touched the soul of the Israeli people and the state of Israel. Many dignitaries wanted to join us tonight, but could not do so because of scheduled conflicts, including an important security cabinet meeting dealing with the fight against terrorism. They all send their wishes to all of us with a special emphasis on their appreciation for the fact that you are here studying in Israel this year. Many have also called Ezra's parents in Boston directly to express their condolences. In a demonstration of how significant tonight's event is and how inspired Israelis are by Ezra's story, we are very thankful that Prime Minister Netanyahu took time from his very busy schedule to send us a special message tonight, both in Hebrew and in English. Please direct your attention to the video screens.
אנחנו כולנו לא אוהבים את יצחקו של עזר. הוא היה חלק מתוכנית מסע, במסע אישי ובעודי שלו, מסע של אהבת עם ישראל ואהבת צבא לעם ישראל. הוא בא לחלק מזון לחיילים. הוא נחצח בידי בני עבלה, שרוצים לרצוח את כל עמנו. והעובדה שאנחנו עזרא, ואת כל אלה שנפלו במערכות ישראל ובקרב על שיקומו של העם היהודי, זו לא עובדה שהיא מובנת מאליו, היא משקפת את רצון החיים של העם שלנו ואת התקומה של העם שלנו, שלצערי כוחה לפעמים באסונות כבדים, כבדים מנצורה, ואנחנו נוסעים בהם. אני רוצה למסור לכם, חבריו של עזרא, אני רוצה למסור למשפחתו את הכאב של העם כולו, וגם את הגאווה של העם כולו. אשרי העם שיש לו בנים כמו עזרא שוורץ. Capacity to defend ourselves against our enemies and the different members. We grieve with his family and with his friends, but we're also very proud. We're proud of Ezra, who came on a personal journey, a Masa, which is our common journey to rebuild the life of the Jewish people in our ancestral homeland, to have our capacity to defend ourselves against our enemies. And the difference in the Jewish destiny today is that we have a state, we have an army. The attacks haven't ended. The desire of those to liquidate us haven't ended. But what has changed is our ability to fight back, to defend ourselves. And unfortunately, this fight often includes very painful casualties, very painful losses, as we've just experienced with Ezra. I want to strengthen and hug his family on behalf of all of us, the people of Israel. But I also want to say that we'll continue this journey. No one will vanquish us.
I would like to call upon Rabbi Akiva Naaman, Ezra's Rebbe at Yeshiva Ashreinu, to speak to us about Ezra. Rabbi Naaman.
Dear Ezra, wow, I miss you so much. I have not stopped crying these past few days. I'm listening to your favorite song as I write this. I keep thinking that I will see you again, that you're going to come into the base with that perpetual smile on your face. How are we supposed to have Gemara Shir without you? Every candle I light this Hanukkah will remind me of the light that you shone everywhere you went. Please continue to shine your beautiful holy light on us from Shamayim. Put in a good word to God for us. Tell him we could really do with some help right now. Ezra, I miss you so much and love you so much. You will always be a part of my heart and my life. I pray that I will be able to exemplify the chesed, happiness, and yearning for Torah that you had. Looking forward to finishing Masechet Sanhedrin together when Mashiach comes, speedily in our days. That is a letter I wrote to Ezra this past Sunday. I had the schus to be Ezra's Rebbe for two hours every morning. Last week, Ezra walked into Shir and said, "Guys, we are doing 75 push-ups every Shir from now on." This was obviously something I couldn't protest or do. After I told him to put his shirt back on, I tried to do the 75 push-ups nonetheless. I finished first. I only did 7 push-ups, but I rounded up. Ezra was always pushing himself, whether it was in the weight room, the base, or on a chesed internship. The whole staff saw him thrive as the year progressed. We saw him mature. We saw him grow. We saw him beginning to succeed in the goals he set out for himself. He wanted to grow more in Gemara. Last week, he would walk into Shir and give me his phone before sitting down to learn so he wouldn't be distracted. He wanted to grow more in Tanakh. Just last Monday night, we sat and learned about Rachel and Leah and the story of the Dudaim. He wanted to grow more in Jewish philosophy. He would learn Pirkei Avos all the time, even in between plays during an NFL game. He so much enjoyed the learning that he did at Eisha Torah's Discovery Program last Wednesday and Thursday. Learning about different proofs for the Torah's divinity really spoke to him. Last Thursday, a man woke up with hate in his heart and killed someone who was so full of love. This one action of hate ripped through the soul of Am Yisrael. Like a drop in a pond, its ripples affecting far beyond its immediate touch, the world felt the pain of this one act of hate. From Ezra's grieving family and the Boston community, to our 5 other heroic Ashrenu students in the van whose lives are forever changed, from our yeshiva, to all of you sitting here and watching online, the Jewish people were wounded. However, like a drop of water in a pond, an act of love also has farther-reaching capabilities than its immediate surrounding. We have seen an immense outpouring of achdus literally all over the world, from the Shiva calls to the communal support, from the GoFundMes to the Google Docs on Siyum Tanakh, to this unprecedented gathering right here tonight. The world has come together to honor and elevate the memory and soul of Ezra Schwartz, Zichrono Livracha. Action. Action is a core value, perhaps the underlying value, in everything in Judaism. We learn in Masechet Kiddushin that we study Torah in order to take action. And Ezra was a man of action. From playing basketball with local underprivileged children right here on this basketball court, to collecting charity for the Israel Cancer Association, Ezra was always helping others, sometimes just by giving a smile and an encouraging word. We are gathered here today to honor and remember Ezra Schwartz. It is our duty, our obligation, to change, to act. There are over 1,200 yeshiva and seminary students here tonight. Make the most of your year. You have so many opportunities every single day to study Torah, to learn about the mitzvot, to become closer to Hashem. So many daily opportunities to do chesed, to show respect and appreciation to your teachers and family, to become a better person. Atem nitzavim kulchem hayom. You are standing here today. Make the most of your year, your months, your weeks, and your days for Ezra. Thank you.
Now, these violent times around the world claimed a local victim far too young this past week. That young man is being remembered here tonight. Let's join stadium PA announcer John Dolan.
Ladies and gentlemen, in a month in which the NFL salutes the service of our brave men and women in our armed forces, we also pause to remember the many who have recently lost their lives in senseless terrorist attacks abroad. Last Thursday, this reality struck close to home when 18-year-old Ezra Schwartz, a native of Sharon, Massachusetts, and a huge Patriots fan, was gunned down nearly 5,500 miles from home while studying abroad. At this time, we would like to honor Ezra Schwartz and the hundreds of victims like him with a moment of silence.
Think that's when I met your mother, the girl of my dreams, the most beautiful woman that I'd ever seen. She said, boy, can I tell you a wonderful thing? I can't help but notice you staring at me. I know I shouldn't say this, but I really believe I can tell by your eyes that you're in love with me. Now, son, telling you this because life can do terrible things.
Pizza!
Pizza at 5 in the morning.
5 in the morning.
5 in the morning.
So we're sitting in the room and talking about some things, and all of a sudden, Ezra just busts out Harry Potter, and, you know, he reads word for word till page 3 in this accent, and it's really funny. And he's having a really bad day at the time, but, like, it cheered me up. And, like, you know, that kind of, that embodies who Ezra was. You're having a bad day, he'd cheer you up.
Harry tried yet again to explain. But she's bored. If I could just let her out at night. Do I look stupid to you? Snarled Uncle Vernon, a bit of fried egg dangling from his bushy moustache.
Now most of the time we'd have too much to drink, and we'd laugh at the stars, and we'd share everything. Too young to notice and too dumb to care. Love was a story that couldn't compare. I said, girl, can I tell you wonderful thing? I made you a present with paper and string, open with care. Now I'm asking you, please, you know that I love you. Will you marry me? Now, son, I'm only telling you this because life can do terrible things. You'll She said, boy, can I tell you a terrible thing? It seems that I'm sick and I've only got weeks. Please don't be sad now, I really believe you were the greatest thing that ever happened to me.
The first weeks at Ashrenu, after a really long QL, we all came back to Ashrenu and started chilling in my room, and as we were, I received a text message that my Shabbos plans had just been canceled. Without anyone else saying anything, Ezra immediately said, Arya, come to my aunt's house for Shabbos. I ended up going, and it was an incredible time, and it was at that moment that I realized how special Ezra really was. Me and him barely even knew each other, maybe 2 or 3 weeks, and he was willing to take me in with open arms to his aunt's house for Shabbos. And I can't even say words. I can't even tell you how much I love Ezra, and I miss him every single day, and he will be missed by everyone.
Do you want to tell us now?
Israeli dignitaries, the United States Ambassador to Israel, Dan Shapiro, very much wanted to join us this evening, but couldn't due to a scheduling conflict. He did send the following message and asked that we read it out loud this evening. Dear students, today is Thanksgiving Day, and my other obligations for the holiday prevent me from being with you this evening. But I am thankful that you have chosen to gather together in this way, in prayer, in study, and a loving memory of your friend and our compatriot, Ezra Schwartz, Zichrono Levracha. I feel confident that even in the midst of their terrible grief, Ezra's family will be thankful as well. As Americans, we are always mindful of our good fortune to live in a land of freedom, opportunity, resources, and an extraordinary capacity for good. We are still and always striving to perfect our union, but our beloved country gives us many blessings to be thankful for. For American Jews, among these blessings are the opportunity to build our own deep and meaningful personal relationships with Israel. That's what Ezra was doing when we lost him. That's what each of you are doing by spending this year of study in Israel. It takes a person in deep touch with their roots, their religion, the history of their people, and their values to put off college so they can grow and learn and experience what you only can by living for a time in Israel. I know, because like all of you, I also chose to spend that time here when I was your age. It remains the most influential experience of my life. These experiences have value beyond the personal growth they foster. They make an undeniable contribution to our Jewish community by making us more knowledgeable, more learned, and more committed Jews. But it even extends to the national level. Through your time here, each of you adds a strengthening strand to the intricate web of ties between the United States and Israel. That is what President Obama told Ezra's parents, Ari and Ruth, when they spoke on Monday. The president said that whether Ezra thought of it this way or not, his studies in Israel added to the bonds between the United States and Israel and between American Jews and Israel. Now, in the most tragic way, his death forms an additional bond between our peoples. Let me just close with a brief word of Torah. In the story of Joseph that is coming up, there are lessons relevant to the reason you gather tonight. In Parshat Vayeshev, which we will read next week, the brothers, in a fit of jealousy over Joseph's dreams, strip him of his colored coat, throw him in a pit, and decide to kill him. But then Judah, the ringleader against Joseph, changes his mind and urges the brothers not to kill him, but to sell him. He rationalizes his suggestion with the words, "Ki achinu b'sarenu hu," for he is our brother, our own flesh. Now, while those words were uttered at a low point in the brothers' relationship with Joseph, they also become the basis for their eventual reconciliation. As Americans and as Jews, we recognize that Ezra was Achinu Bisarenu, our brother, our own flesh. That is as good a reason as any to come together tonight to honor him through prayer, study, and fellowship. Thank you for what you are doing tonight and throughout your time in Israel. In friendship, Dan Shapiro, United States Ambassador. The next part of the program is somewhat surreal. To the north of where we stand tonight, Shimshon walked along Nachal Sorek. To the south is the battlefield of David and Goliath. And where we are right now, Beit Shemesh, the Aron, the Ark of the Covenant, returned to the camp of Israel after it was captured by the Plishtim. We are located in a city surrounded by Tanakh, and it is so fitting that we will be completing the Tanakh right here. From the moment we got the news regarding what happened to Ezra, there has been a pillar of strength who has shown all of us, and especially the boys at Yeshivat Ashreinu, how we can balance the horrific emotions of the loss with the will and determination to carry on here in our beloved Eretz Yisrael. It's an honor for me to call upon Rabbi Gatz Yudin, Rabbi Rosh Yeshiva of Ashreinu, to introduce the learning that we will do tonight in Ezra's memory.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are about to do something incredible. We all know that Ezra Alav HaShalom had an amazing goal to finish Tanakh this year. We as a Tzibur, as one strong unit, in the next 15 to 20 minutes, will have the opportunity to learn and complete the entire Tanakh in Ezra's memory. When we came together as a people, when we come together as a people, there is no putting us down. In a week from this Sunday, we will all be lighting our first Hanukkah candle. I want you all to remember this moment when you say the words, Bayamim Haheim, Bazman Hazeh, that our enemies have tried throughout the ages to knock us down. And I have one message for all of the terrorists out there. It is not working. You are only making us stronger. We today are fulfilling the prophecy of the Navi Yirmiyahu that we are about to learn, that is found in Perek Lamed Pasuk Zion, where the Navi tells us, Ve'et tzara hi li Yaakov umimena yivashea, which means, in an exceedingly difficult time for the Jewish people, from the very tzara, from the very sorrow, we will become stronger. Stronger for our convictions for Torah, stronger in our convictions to Eretz Yisrael, and stronger in our convictions to do kindness and to be better people. We have this chut now. You've all received sheets as you've walked in here. And for the next 15 minutes, we will have this chut to complete, to begin and complete all of Tanakh in memory of Ezra.
כאשר בורא עולם ברא את האדם, נתן לכולם דם באותו צבע. ואני קורא לכל מדינות העולם להבין ולהכיר במלחמה המתמדת של העם היהודי מול סך הכל זכותם לחיות ולא למות ולא להירצח. ואני שמח שהעם שלנו שייך לצערנו לעם הנרצח ולא לעם הרוצח.
In conclusion, the mayor wants to point out that all the terror that's being experienced around the world, we're all victims together. There's no difference between blood and blood. We're all human beings together. We all suffer from the terrorism together. And hopefully the countries of the world will recognize that we are all in this together and fighting the same enemy together. And the mayor concluded by saying that he's proud to be part of the nation that's being victimized instead of a nation that's acting with terror.
לסיום אני רוצה באמת להודות להנהלת הישיבה היקרה, לראש הישיבה, לכל הצוות, כמובן גם כן להנהלה של קריית חינוך, הרב רזיאל והרב פטרוביץ' והרב אביגדור בורשטיין, לידידי דוב שבאמת מלווה את המשפחות. אני רוצה לומר לכם גם תודה לכל עובדי עיריית בית שמש שהגיעו באותו יום, הצוותות שלנו של עובדי הרווחה והשירות הפסיכולוגי, כולם הגיעו כדי לתת כתף לאותו אירוע שקרה ושלא יקרה יותר. ולהגיד לכולם, אנחנו כולנו, כל בית שמש, אוהבים אתכם. העיר בית שמש מחבקת אתכם. ומקווה בעזרת השם שזה יהיה השבר האחרון של הטרור וקורא לכל מדינת ישראל. תזכרו את אותם תלמידים תמימים שרוצים סך הכל לגדול ללא איום ופחד.
In conclusion, the mayor thanks the staff here at Kiryat Chinuch of the yeshiva, all the workers in the city, municipality, many who came the night that Ezra was killed to be here, social workers to help out with the boys and to be of assistance. And he really thanks everyone for being here, for all the city of Beit Shemesh. We come together in this sad time and we hope that this is the last time we have to come together in these kinds of sad circumstances as we pray for much better times ahead.
אנחנו נגיע לכאן רק לאירועים משמחים מהיום ומאחלים לכולם גם חנוכה שמח.
From this point on, we will get together here and other places just for happy occasions, and the mayor wishes everyone a very happy Hanukkah.
Shabbat Shalom.
We thank Mayor Abutbol and the city of Beit Shemesh, and we thank the mayor for those words. All of Ezra's friends, those he grew up with in Boston, his new friends in Israel, have spent this past week crying together, grieving together, and mourning together. But they have also laughed together as they spoke about their memories of Ezra, and perhaps most significantly, they have also been singing together. Many of us experienced this at the airport when we all gathered together to say goodbye to Ezra. It is only fitting that we continue to sing tonight. I call on some of Ezra's friends from Ashreinu to the stage to sing an original song about their good friend, Ezra.
Thank you, everyone, for coming. And thank you to everyone who put this together in such a short notice. Just one thing, Ezra, you would rap all the time in our dorms, just joke raps that we made, and Ezra loved to listen to them all the time, so we just wrote a rap song for Ezra, so this is for you, Ezra.
All you want to do is run away and hide. You have a friend one second standing by your side, and a wave of hate crashes, washed by the tide. Could this happen? Like lightning striking our souls, filling up an empty, fragile boat of smoke. We're coughing, we can't breathe. Eyes are tearing because it's hard to see, to perceive, to receive, and to have peace of mind, to leave all our hardships and anger behind. To put life on hold, stop, pause, slow motion, go back and rewind. I just need to know that there's meaning. This feeling, my heart pounds, my screams pierce through the ceiling. The same thought repeats like a broken record. This can't be real, I'm not sure what to feel. Just please God, world, let Ezra's light remain. Let it shine on and let it be revealed.
See him every night, he's a star above us. Every time we cry, we know he'll always love us. Still remember that Thursday, man, it was the worst day. First time I chill with you, straight up, you're putting the crew. Trying to make the best of it, trying to make the best of it without my best friend. Feeling 83%, shout out to Griner, Shlomo, Joe, Mike, and Mason. We're here for you, and you're all amazing. Me and Ezra used to do the wildest things. Say, oh, remember me. Now you're always me in my wildest dreams.
Happiness to work through the hard time and through all the madness. I'll cherish his memory forever as the boy that can make me smile whenever. Rest in peace, my good friend. I will remember you till my end. They think they will pull us apart. However, for you, Ezra, we unite together. Ezra is the kid with the smile. His friendship pushed me to go the extra mile. We will never get your smile through the weather. No matter how bad it gets, we love you forever.
Thank you, guys. That was really beautiful and really meaningful. All of us have been touched to see the depth of connection that exists between the students from Maimonides. This week has shown all of us just how special a school it is and just how special the Boston Jewish community is. I would like to ask Atara Saltzman, who is studying in Tiferet this year and is the daughter of Rabbi Saltzman, the principal of the Maimonides Lower School, to represent Ezra's classmates from Boston with her thoughts and her memories. Atara.
Hi. As Yaakov prepares to encounter his brother Esav, Rashi states that Yaakov readied himself in three ways. He sent gifts, he prepared for war, and he davened to Hashem. Rashi comments that he prepared for war by dividing his camp into two, so that if one camp was struck down by the enemy, as the Pasuk says, Im yavo Esav el hamachane ha'achat v'hikahu, if Esav comes to one camp and strikes it down, the other camp will be able to run away, as the pasuk says, v'haya hamachane hanishar lifleita, the remaining camp will escape. I feel like Yaakov's fears of destruction to some of his family were actualized this past week with the murder of our friend Ezra Schwartz. Ezra was a member of our Maimonides family who was struck down last week. The remaining members of his class are the Fleita. We are the friends who remain and want to perpetuate his memory. Although many of Ezra's closest friends from our grade could not be here tonight, they are still in America, they have so graciously shared their memories of him with me. Most of you here have never met Ezra and didn't know him in the capacity that we did. And I'd like to share a few short stories about him with you. Our friend Kayla shared that one day during school she was sick, but she was unable to go home. Ezra decided to skip all of his classes that day so he could be with her. He took care of her. He got her something when she needed it. He told her jokes, and he sat with her the entire day so she wouldn't be alone. Last year, for Ezra's senior volunteer project, he decided to spend his time volunteering at Shas Preschool, the Jewish Modern Orthodox preschool in Sharon that Ezra himself attended years ago. Ezra loves sports and could easily have spent his time volunteering with older kids somewhere, playing sports and hanging out with people closer to his own age. But he decided to spend every Wednesday volunteering with toddlers. Ezra spent his time at Shas sitting on the floor with the toddlers and being silly, playing with them, finding every possible way to make them laugh. He was gentle and caring, and he wasn't afraid to make himself look silly if it was to bring happiness to those kids' faces. Last February, our friend Donnie and his family went away with Ezra's family skiing in Vermont. One afternoon, while everyone was bored, Ezra came up with the idea to jump off their second-story deck into the deep snow below. Everyone thought it was a fun idea. However, no one wanted to be the first to jump. But Ezra got up and stood up on that railing and jumped right off into the snow without a second thought. Everyone followed after him, and the jumping continued for another 2 hours. Ezra was a leader. When he did something, everybody followed. He was fearless, and he lived in the moment. I was reflecting last night with our principal, Rabbi Huff, and he pointed something out to me. Ezra had an incredible memory. Stories and videos have come up of Ezra reciting scenes word for word from books like Harry Potter, as you saw. Ezra had set himself the goal of completing all of Tanakh. It was his goal. It was what he wanted to do. With the amazing memory he had, said Rabbi Huff, and his perseverance to study hard, he would have been able to recite prakim upon prakim for us. Who else do you know that could do such a thing? And now we have taken upon ourselves to finish Tanakh the way he could not. The Schwartz family, the Sharonites, Maimonides' class of 2015, and all of Am Yisrael have suffered an incalculable loss. Ezra loved life. People of all ages were attracted to him, drawn to his contagious and constant cheerfulness and spirit. It is so sad that this was the person who was taken from us so early because he just loved life. He loved having fun. Even though Ezra is no longer with us physically, the ideals he stood for will always live on. To be there for our friends in time of need, to get out of bed every morning simply because we want to make others smile, and to live every second that we are given on this earth to its fullest, and to not take for granted the people in our lives. On Sunday, Ezra's father, Ari, said that their family will never be complete again. So too, our Sharon, Maimonides, and Boston families will never again be complete. But no matter what point we are in our lives in the future, we will never forget Ezra and the special things that he taught us. To Ruth, Ari, Molly, Hillel, Ilan, and Avi, who are watching right now from their home in Sharon, Ezra's name and his legacy will always be known to us in our community. And in our hearts, he will be alive forever. That's it. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Atara. And now I would like to call all the Ashrenu students back to the stage and ask Moshe Fryer and Josh Melamed to share their thoughts and memories about Ezra.
Thank you. Ezra Schwartz was not just my friend. Ezra Schwartz was not just my friend. He was my brother. My name is Joshua Malamed, and though I only knew Ezra for 3 months, I feel so blessed to have the pleasure for not only meeting Ezra, but also having him as one of my closest friends at Yeshiva. For those of you who know Ezra well, you know that he really enjoyed skiing. There was one day that Ezra called me into his room, and we were lying in his bed as he was showing me some of his pictures of him skiing, which I thought was pretty cool. Ezra went on to showed me some videos of professional skiers. I wasn't so interested in skiing, but the amount of passion that he showed made him so happy. And whenever I saw Ezra smiling, I couldn't do anything else but smile right back at him. My favorite part of the week was every Sunday, where our squad would go out and buy Schweppes, pita, harif, and hummus before we would watch the football games. We would all gather around one desk with 3 computers, streaming 3 different games at each time. It really brought us closer as friends, and it was always a good time. Ezra showed me how much you can learn from someone in such a short period of time. I believe that Ezra was really making a difference. He made the most out of his year, both with his growth as a person as well as in his studies. Before he was murdered, he took it upon himself to finish all of Tanakh, and I am planning on finishing what he started. He will be missed dearly by his family, which includes our Yeshivat Ashreinu family and all of Klal Yisrael. He will always be in my memory, and I will always cherish the time that I spent with him. I have never had someone so close to me pass away, and it confuses me. I'm wondering, why did this have to happen? And I realized it will never make sense to me. The only explanation that I have is that he perfected himself in these past couple of months. I'm going to miss him every day of my life. My heart goes out to his family. No one deserves to lose a friend, brother, or a son at such a young age. Our yeshiva raised money so that we could fully commemorate his passing, and I, on the behalf of our yeshiva, would like to thank everyone who donated money to the cause. When we saw Ezra off to Boston, it struck me that he was only in Israel for 3 months, but there were clearly so many people that were affected by such a special person. I will treasure all the memories that Ezra and I have together, and will pass on his memory for as long as I live. Thank you.
Hello. Hello, my name is Moshe Fryer, and I would like to thank everybody who took the time to come out tonight. About a week into school, our yeshiva took us on a trip up north. One of the hikes we took, I spent the whole time talking about football to a kid by the name of Ezra Schwartz. That was our first conversation. He told me that he didn't know anybody coming to school. I, on the other hand, knew many kids before Israel. After that hike, I went straight to my friend and told him about this guy, Ezra Schwartz, who was about to become our new best friend. I didn't come here to talk about Ezra's Torah and Chesed values, because I can go on for that all day. I think you guys have heard enough about that. I want to talk about how Ezra was a fun-loving, nice guy who was an amazing friend. Ezra had that perfect Ashreinu crazy, something that all of us have, rabbis and students alike. Sure, we learn and do tons of Chesed, but what sets us apart is that we are a bunch of crazy guys that can have fun anywhere. Ezra was no doubt the epitome of our school. One time we decided to play tackle football. It was all fun and well, but apparently that kind of activity is frowned upon in the middle of Mahal Mahal. Ezra was, of course, front and center of that. He was always looking to have some fun. Ezra was the best friend a guy could ask for. After hurting my knee, Ezra always walked with me while I limped around. Sometimes, I would ask Ezra to go places with me, like the supermarket or Pizza Shemesh. He wouldn't really want to go, but he would just respond to me in the cutest way. He would just be like, "You know I can't say no to you." One time, at 2:30 in the morning, Ezra and I were just hanging out with our friend Adam Gornstein, and he told us there was this store that was open really late at night, and it was a 10-minute walk away. So we walked there, and there was no store. And then Ezra was like, I don't know what happened. But a week later, he comes to us, and he's like, I took you guys out because I just wanted to hang out with you. And that was just the type of friend he was. All he wanted to do was hang out with his buddies. I would just like to end with a message to everyone who loved Ezra as much as I did. This is not something that we can get over, but together, something that we can get through.
Thank you so much, guys. While the next part, of the program is getting ready, just wanted to share with all of you. After we're done here tonight, many, if not all of you, are going to be going to Yerushalayim to dance at an incredible wedding. And I got a call 2 days ago from a group that arrived in Israel late last night from Montreal, Canada. The rabbi there, Rabbi Mark Fishman, heard about Sarah Tachia Littman's call for people to join her at her wedding. And he said, I'm sitting here in Montreal, Canada, and a young girl who has just lost her father and brother have called for all of Am Yisrael to join her at her wedding. How can we not go? And he stood up at the podium last Shabbat, and he called on people in his shul to join him. And a plane with 12 people from his shul arrived here for a 3-day trip just to be at the wedding tonight. That group includes a grandfather, son, and their grandson. It also includes 2 people who have never been in Israel before. And it also includes a couple that have been saving money for about 5 years to refurbish their basement. And when they heard about Sarah Tachia's call, they said, we can hold off on refurbishing the basement. We're taking that money and we're going to Israel to dance together with Sarah Tachia and her chatan at the wedding. This is the kind of people that we are, and this is what we're showing here tonight as well. Ladies and gentlemen, and young men and women, and all of you who are watching on the video stream, let's all raise our voices together in song. The song can cross the ocean together. And with the help of 2 of the most talented and inspirational singers that I know, Chaim David and Shlomo Katz, let's sing all of Am Yisrael together. Thank you.
Israel. V'al Yovad, V'al Yovad, V'al Yovad Israel, Omrim Shema Israel.
Consolation has yet to come, and we've been waiting since the Henkin family on Sukkot for the Nechama, for an end of this. But it must be that we're right there by the Neirot Chanukah. It has to be that by the even before the Chanukah candles, that the Neirot of Chanukah are going to come and console us. As the Hasidic masters explain, we light the Chanukah, the menorah, Ner Chanukah, Mosi Feholech. We keep on adding more and more and more. Like tonight, this huge menorah that's been lit in the Schus of Ezra all over the world. Ner Chanukah, Mosi Feholech. That's the Rosh Tevos of that word that we're waiting for, Nachamo. It should be a real consolation for Am Yisrael. Enough is enough. After this Askara, going to a Simcha. And the Nechama should happen for everyone, all of us. From here to be Amenu.
Oh,
Hey.
And now for the highlight, the reason why we came together tonight to finish all of Tanakh, Le'iloi Nishmat, Yechiel Ezra ben Ari Yona, to complete the Tanakh that Ezra so badly wanted to complete himself. I call upon Rabbi Eli Skase from Yeshivat Eshreinu to complete Tanakh. At the conclusion of the Siyum, despite our sadness, we will celebrate together as well this amazing accomplishment. We ask everyone to dance at your seats, together as one. And I hope as we do so, that you can even feel Ezra's neshama and the neshamot of all the Kedoshim dancing together with us here. Rabbi Skase.
Before we start and we celebrate, Derech Eretz is Kadma LaTorah. My home, I was blessed to grow up to hear from my parents that every day is Thanksgiving. And I would be remiss if we did not thank Dr. Portovich, the founder of the Jaffa Institute and Kiryat Chinuch, for opening up their campus and their home for us here. There are four people without whom this event would not have happened. My dear friend Hillel Scheinfeld, Rabbi Dov Lippman, Rabbi Jonathan Cohen, and Rabbi Moshe Benovitz. Our incredible staff at Yeshivat Eshreinu, and most importantly, the incredible students of Yeshivat Eshreinu. Thank you.
So as you can imagine, it's been a difficult week for all of us, for all of Am Yisrael. And I kept on thinking throughout this week, who are we as a people? And I kept on thinking of the pasuk of Sheva Yipol Tzadik V'Kam. And we know that they could put us down, they can kill us, they can murder us on the streets. But the one thing, the powerful thing that we have is V'Kam, is that we know how to get up. We just had the most unbelievable zechut together to finish Tanakh right here. As a one, the Tanakh, Sifrei HaSfarim, the holiest of holies, Kodesh HaKodeshim. The final pasuk of Tanakh, Ko Amar Koresh Melech Paras, Kol Mamlachot Haaretz, Natan Li Adonai Elohe HaShamayim, Hu Pakad Alai Livnot Lo Bayit, בירושלים אשר ביהודה. מי בכם מכל עמו אדוני אלוהיו אמו ויעל. The final concluding word is ויעל. This is the answer. The answer is ויעל. We need to get up. We need to go up. We need to stand up and be strong together. הדרן הלך סדר תנ"ך והדרך הלן. דעתן הלך סדר תנ"ך ודעתה חלן. לא נתנשים מנך סדר תנ"ך ולא תתנשים מנן, לא בעלמא דם ולא בעלמא דעתי. הדרן הלך סדר תנ"ך והדרה חלן, דעתן הלך סדר תנ"ך ודעתה חלן. לא נתנשים מנך סדר תנ"ך ולא תתנשים מנן, לא בעלמא דם ולא בעלמא דעתי. הדרן הלך סדר תנ"ך והדרה חלן, דעתן הלך סדר תנ"ך ודעתה חלן. לא נתנשים מנך סדר תנ"ך ולא תתנשים מנן, לא בעלמא דם ולא בעלמא דעתי. יהי רצון מלפניך, אדוני אלוהינו ולאבותינו, שתהא תורתך אומנותנו בעולם הזה, ותהא עמנו לעולם הבא, חנינא בר פפא, רמי בר פפא, נחמן בר פפא, אחי בר פפא, אבא מרי בר פפא, רפרם בר פפא, רחיש בר פפא, סורחב בר פפא, עדה בר פפא, דרו בר פפא, ערב נא אדוני אלוהינו את דברי תורתך בפינו, בפיות עמך בית ישראל, ונהיה אנחנו וצאצאינו וצאצאי עמך בית ישראל, כולנו יודעי שמך ולומדי תורתך לשמה, מאויבי תחכמני, מצוותיך כי לעולם היא לי, יהא ליבי תמים בחוקיך למען לא יבוש, לעולם לא אשכח פקודיך כי בם חייתני, ברוך אתה אדוני למדני חוקיך, אמן אמן אמן, סלע ועד. יהי רצון מלפניך, אדנו אלוהינו ולאבותינו, ששמת חלקנו מיושבי בית המדרש ולא שמת חלקנו מיושבי קרנות, שאנו משכימים והם משכימים, אנו משכימים לדברי תורה והם משכימים לדברים מטלים, אנו עמלים והם עמלים, אנו עמלים ומקבלים שכר והם עמלים ואינם מקבלים שכר, אנו רצים והם רצים, אנו רצים לחיי העולם הבא והם רצים לבאר שחת, שנאמר ואתה אלוהים תורידם לבאר שחת, אנשי דמים ומרמה לא יחצו עמהם ואני אבטח בך. יהי רצון מלפניך, אדוני אלוהי, כשם שעזרתנו לסיים סדר תנ"ך, כן תעזרנו להתחיל מסכתות וספרים אחרים ולסיימם, ללמוד וללמד, לשמור ולעשות ולקיים את כל דברי תלמוד תורתך באהבה, וזכות כל התנאים והמוראים ותלמידי חכמים יעמדו לנו ולזרענו, שלא תמוש התורה מפינו ומפי זרענו וזרע זרענו עד עולם, ויתקיים בנו ויתהלכך, תנחה אותך ובשרבך תשמור עליך, והקיצות ההיא תשיחך, כי וי ירבו ימיך ויוסיפו לך שנות חיים, אורך ימים בימינה, בשמאלה עושר וכבוד, אדוני עוז לעמו ייתן, אדוני יברך את עמו בשלום. יתגדל ויתקדש מי רבה, ועלמדו עתיד להתחדתה ולהחיה מיתיה ולעסקה לחיי עולמה ולמבנה קרתה דיור שלם ולשכלל יחלה בגבה ולמעיקר פולחנה נוכרה מערה ולעתיו הפולחנה דשמה להתרה וימליך קודשה בריחו במלכותי ויקרי ויצמח פורקני ויקרי משיחי בחיי חון וביום חון ובחיי דכל בית ישראל בעגלה וזמן קריב אמרו אמן. יש מי רבה מבורך לעולם ולעולמי עולמיה, יתברך וישתבח ויתפאר ויתרומם ויתנשא ויתהדר ויתעלה ויתהלה שמי דקודשה בריחו לילה מכל ברכתה ושירתה תושבחתה ונחמתה דמירן בעלמה ואמרו אמן על ישראל ועל רבנן ועל תלמידי הון ועל כל תלמידי תלמידי הון ועל כל מן דעוסקין באורייתא דיבתרא קדישא הדין ודי בכל אתר ואתר יהי לעון ולכון שלמה רבה חינה וחיסה ורחמין וחיין עריכין ומזוני רוויחי ופורקנה מין קדם אבון די ושמיה ואמרו אמן. יהי שלמה רבה מין שמיה וחיים טובים עלינו ועל כל ישראל ואמרו אמן. עושה שלום במרומיו, הוא יעשה שלום עלינו ועל כל ישראל ואמרו אמן.
of asking everyone to take all this energy, make your way back towards your seats for a moment so we can bring tonight's event to an orderly conclusion. Remember, we're gonna take all that energy that we just had with us to Yerushalayim. Everyone, please just very quickly and quietly make your way back to where you were just a few moments ago. Again, everybody, please make your way to your seats. Again, if everyone can make your way back to your seats, please. There are a few very important announcements, safety announcements, before we finish tonight. So everyone, please make your way back to your seats. Thank you so much for your cooperation. A few announcements. First of all, when we begin the process of leaving the area, we ask everybody's help in the row where you're sitting. If everyone, not yet, when we finish tonight, can stack the chairs in their row, not yet, but this will be in the spirit of chesed. Each one of you taking 10 seconds to stack your rows will do a big help to those who are cleaning up afterwards. Number two, there are garbage cans all over the area. We ask that you please make sure that you put your water bottles or any water bottles around you inside of those garbage cans. Number three, the sheets that you have are shamos. We're asking all of you to stack them on the tables in the back so that we should not, God forbid, disgrace the shamos that you have with you. Last Thursday night, just hours after Ezra's soul left this world, the boys of Ashreinu gathered in a circle and sang the most beautiful Atikvah that I have ever heard. That same scene was repeated together with his friends from Boston and everyone who gathered at the airport on Saturday night. All of us should ask ourselves a question. What would our great-grandparents have given for the opportunity to spend just 5 minutes breathing the air of the land of Israel? And all of us have been blessed by God to live in a time where we can visit here, tour here, spend a year or two of learning here, or choose to live here. Despite the difficult and challenging times in which we live, we also live in the most magnificent and miraculous of times. As we bring tonight's program to a close, I ask all of you to rise together and let's declare together that despite the tragedy of Ezra's passing, despite all the tragic losses that we have suffered, especially over the last 2 months, we will channel that pain and grow even stronger and reaffirm our commitment to Tzion, to the land of Israel, to the Torah of Israel, to Medinat Yisrael, with the singing together of Hatikva.
Liot am chofshim.